I'd like to get everyone's attention for this part because we enter a part of the evening now that I suppose you could say comes with mixed emotions. Thank you. Thank you, Ben's partner. Where we honour our retirees, so please turn your attention to the screen. Where I still am. Nope, no, I'm not.
Taking over this town, they should worry. But these problems aside, I think I taught you well. That we won't run, and we won't run, and we won't run. And in the winter night sky, ships are sailing, looking down on these bright blue city lights. And they won't wait.
Great, that was really well put together. I was smiling all the way through that one. Now, ahead of round 14, one of the giants in Australian netball's, well, one of Australia's netball's most lovable characters, April Brandley, announced that this season will be her last. The Sutherland Shire junior completes her netball career spanning 13 seasons, 5 clubs and 153 National League games. I'm all choked up. And 99 Super Netball games. Oh, so close. As well as an international career which saw her represent the Australian Diamonds on 39 occasions, including a silver medal at both the Commonwealth Games and a Netball World Cup. Brandley joined the Giants ahead of the 2020 season, going on to play 58 games, including her 100th and 150th milestone matches. She was awarded the Giants Players Player in 2021 and will forever leave her mark on the Giants family. I would now like to invite one of her teammates, Amy Parmenter, to the stage to speak on behalf of the playing group.
Choked up too, actually. So, Mads, I might need you to come over here and read the rest of my speech. Okay, so I have this really small writing. I wasn't going to admit this, but when I was at Officeworks today, I did like print off the small A4 version, and I was like, oh, it's going to be too small. It's not till 9:30. I've had a few champagne, so I was like, I might as well print off the A3 version as well, just in case. So it's coming out. Sorry, Dad. My dad said I was going to make a goose of myself, and I'm doing it. I feel like I'm here not just to talk about the amazing netballer that we just saw April is, but to also talk about the amazing person and teammate that she is as well. And in my opinion, that's almost more important. When I started putting down a few things for this speech, all I could think about was how much I was going to miss you and all the things that you bring to this team. So it's just a big long list of all the things I'm going to miss about you. We're going to miss your extremely inappropriate and usually sexual one-liners. I would give you a few examples, but Laura will probably kick me off the stage. But thank you always for making us laugh. We're going to miss your contribution to team huddles. It was always a silent but deadly approach. We're going to miss drugged up April that took too much Panadine for one game and was off with the fairies and running away from the ball. We're going to miss the days when you took hairdressing into your own hands, and every day you'd show up to training with hair being a slightly different colour of the rainbow. Mostly I am going to miss having someone that matches my level of over-the-top drama when they slightly roll their ankle and have to crawl off the court acting like they need an ambulance and a green whistle, giving Shamira Sterling a slight run for her money. We're going to miss our Clayboy. Thank you and Jace for creating the most beautiful baby boy who has brightened up our days for the last few years. He is so lucky to have you two as his parents, and we are so grateful that we got to be a part of his journey as he continues to be the most kind-natured and speediest kid I know. We're going to miss the way you always get on everyone's level and that you just care about everyone so much. We're going to miss the way you never lead with judgment and you always see the best in people. We're going to miss the way you wear your heart on your sleeve in such a raw and genuine way. Your energy and your vulnerability is so warm and infectious. Sorry, 1 second. But most of all, we're going to miss seeing you be the most incredible role model, mum and friend every day. I don't think you will ever fully appreciate the impact you have had on us and on so many netballers coming through the pathway wanting to be like you one day. I'm a strong believer that there are certain people that come into your life for a reason. I have a feeling that our mums are up there drinking a shardy or five and laughing at how this was all part of their master plan to bring us together. You have taught me so much, and I hang so tightly to every word of wisdom you give me because it feels like you get me more than anyone. You have taught me not to sweat the small stuff and that there are so many more important things in life than just being a good netballer. In your words, don't be a dickhead. And I can't tell you how much confidence and self-belief you have helped me gain. I really don't know what I'm going to do without you next year, and I know I'm not the only one in the room asking the same questions. Just so you know, it's not too late to change your mind. We love you so much, April, and we are going to miss you more than you'll miss playing Ted Ball, even if your talent only showed up 50% of the time. Good luck with everything ahead of you, and we can't wait to sit back and watch you shine.
There was real 21st vibes in that speech, I think. And it was nice of you to print it out poster size so she can put it on a wall later, it's great. Well done. And it's not just April that we farewell tonight, and we keep hearing it over and over, and we see it as well, and I think especially probably because of the hub, but her partner, Jason and son Claire, are such a big part of this it seems to be such a big part of this team as well, and the journey that April has had, and leave their own mark and memories within this group. But he can't be with us tonight because it's way past his bedtime, but we do have a little something for our littlest and most loved giant, Clay, and to remember his time at the Giants, and to speak on his behalf, and perhaps also her own, if there's time, please welcome April Brandley.
My turn. Oh God, I'm really nervous. I'm probably gonna cry, let's be honest, it's me. Thank you, Parmy, and that was just so beautiful and it means the world to me. Thank you so much for those beautiful words. And breathe, okay. Here we go. So firstly, I wanna say thank you to my family for supporting and inspiring me to be my best. Thanks, Dad, for continuing the journey with me and supporting me in your own unique way. Hiding raw eggs in my smoothies when I was 13 to try and bulk me up. Anyway, you're always pushing me to be my best and not care about what other people say and give things a go, and I really thank you for that. It's been a real journey from early days at Heathcote Waratahs in our little community, playing my first game underage and unregistered. Oops, sorry, not New South Wales. I then got my first taste of competition at state age with Sutherland, where it was all about cornrows, shirt and sock tans, and where I met my best friends and thought, hey, I actually really like this game. Then on to representing New South Wales at Nationals, and to wear the Waratah with pride was our life mission. I'll never forget the fierce rivalry we had against Victoria. We would absolutely fight to the death. It was a really cool time, and I've never felt so driven and committed to anything than when I did representing New South Wales. It really opened up a doorway of my love for the game and gave me a taste of where I wanted to go and what was actually possible. Now, I'm not going to go into all the teams that I've played from, what I've learnt from each of them, otherwise we'll be here till midnight. So let's get on to thanking these beautiful, special people that I've loved being with at the Giants. To Julie and Jenny, P.S. I've never heard you swear, so hearing that video of you saying shoot, it was actually hilarious. Sorry. To Julie and Jenny, thank you for taking me and my boys literally on the road with you and embracing me and my family as part of the package deal. As coaches, you both set the standard for all the clubs, supporting mums coming back into the sport, and I feel blessed that you welcome me with open arms. Jules, thank you for always believing in me and giving me the opportunities that you have. These past 4 years, like, it's really been some of the fondest memories of my career. I wasn't sure if I was ready to come back after having Clay, but you really supported me and gave me confidence when I felt vulnerable and unsure, especially at the beginning. So thank you. Next page. I've only got A4s, not A3s. Even though she's not here, big thanks to Physio Gem and Dr. Soph. I really made them work very hard this year for their money. Sorry about that. We were besties for most of the year for all the wrong reasons, but honestly, I wouldn't have been able to hit the court if it wasn't for all the work that you did with me behind the scenes. Not only the physical work, but also the mental and emotional side as well. You're absolute professionals, special humans that are leaders in your field, and Giants and myself are very lucky to have you. All right. Big thank you to S&C Tom, who's also not here, but I'll just say it anyway, whatever. Even though your Ted Ball antics and umpiring are very questionable, you've been integral in helping me get strong and fit and back out there on court. I remember there was a moment when I was having a bit of a sad sack moment. My body was not being kind to me, and Ted and TR gave me this pep talk. And he's like, he just instilled so much confidence in me. He's like, I'm going to get you thriving, not surviving. And it was a real pivotal moment that I remember that helped me change better for mentally. So thanks, TR. Little dad pep talk. Appreciate that. Oh, Denny, where do I start? You've just, this is where I'm going to get a bit emotional. Sorry. Every. There's not enough words I could say to thank you for what you have done, not only to support me, but the way you've... Oh, Jesus. but the way you've embraced Clay has really meant the world to me. It's so special to see the connection that you two have. You're honestly the GOAT. Clay loves his Denny days at the club, and it's made it so fulfilling for me to be able to bring him on the journey and not miss any parts of motherhood that I wanted to experience. We've gained an extra member to our family, and none of this would have been possible without you. We love you dearly, and thank you so, so much. Massive thank you to Laura, who's also one of Clay's babysitters and absolute superstars. I've loved getting to know you over these past 4 years, and you're literally just like a best friend. So thank you so much for all you've done with the whole like retirement thing. It's just been absolutely perfect for me and my family. Thank you so much for that, and yeah, you're the best. And Kez, I'm so glad we got to come to Giants together. Me and Kez worked together in Collingwood. That no longer exists, obviously. Thank you to you. Rest in peace. No, I think when I first met Kez, she was just starting out in the position, and to see how she's come, the growth in her as a person and at her job, like, she's an absolute superstar, PA and person, and you'll be definitely missed. So thank you for everything, Kez. No, I promise I'm nearly done. No, you'll never have to hear from me ever again. Just joking, sorry. Too soon? All right. I'll stop. A massive thank you to Tim, the Giants, Netball New South Wales, Tracy. There's so many of you, I could be here for 2 hours. But from the get-go, when I first met with Tim, I remember I had a full page of questions, like, how's this going to work? How's that going to work? What will happen with Clay, etc. And I remember walking out being like, oh my gosh, like, this is really happening, we're going to do this. Nothing was ever an issue, and I felt really supported the whole way. Giants set the club the standard against other clubs and lead the way to support women who don't want to have to choose between family and their passion. And you providing the opportunity to commingle the two is just absolutely incredible. So thank you to Giants, Netball New South Wales, and the incredible staff for embracing me and my family. This experience has been better than I could ever imagine. I'm so proud to be a Giant, and it's testament to the people and the club you are building and creating. So thank you so much, everyone. Thank you to the girls, legends, love you guys. I've been so fortunate to be around strong, smart, fierce, caring, loyal, supportive, independent women. I really do mean that. These girls have seen me at my absolute best and my absolute worst, and they still love me, I hope. Sorry, I'm a bit psycho sometimes. They have always embraced me and my family and all the craziness in between. I've honestly loved getting to know each and every one of you. We have a lot of banter and inappropriate jokes and push each other to the limits on and off the court. The friendships and the daily in and outs with the girls is honestly the thing that I'll miss the most about retiring. It's been so special seeing the youngies grow and develop in confidence and the older ones grow in their leadership and impact. Each person's story in our team has had a profound impact on me and inspired me through the 4 years. I could talk about every single one of these girls for 2 hours. They've all inspired me so much and made, I don't know, you're just absolutely the best. So thank you so much, girls. I love you all. Okay. It really takes a village, and my husband is the diamond in the rough that I was lucky to find. He's my number one supporter, netball enthusiast, and a little chatterbox who I love dearly. None of this would have worked if I didn't have the person in you by my side through all of it. You left jobs after one day to come into Hub Life. You've picked me up when I'm down, and you've been there to make the good times even better. Thanks for everything, Jay. None of this would have happened or been anywhere near as fulfilling without you by my side. Thank you to the grandparents. Got to give the grandparents a shout out. Nanny, Poppy and Gran, just for everything that you've done to make this whole thing work. Last minute phone calls, picking up, dropping off Clay, sick mum. I couldn't have done it without you. It really does take a village, and I appreciate all you've done for me and Jay behind the scenes. Lastly, I'm just so grateful for, I really am so grateful for netball and everything that it's given to my life, the coaches that have given me a go and teammates that have become family over the years. It has given me so much. It's hard to put into words the impact the people and the game has had on my life. It's taken me and my whole family on an incredible adventure, and I always feel so grateful for. It's not a goodbye, it's a see around. Thank you.
We have a little presentation as well for April, so please stay up standing. Julie, would you mind coming and do the honours? We have two, actually. One for you and one for Clay.
Oh, oh, that's so nice. Yeah.
Sure you can. One more big round of applause for April Brandley. Oh, that's wonderful.